All right, so my name is Chris Perry. I'm also RNW Corgi, as some people may know. I'm from Dallas, Texas, and right now I work for BMW, but hope to change that. So I have the pleasure of talking with Mr. Crypto Dane here. If you would please go ahead and give us a brief introduction of yourself, like what you do, where you're from, and your product, what you want to bring out, and how you want to essentially, make that a reality, I
Sure.
guess.
All right. Well, everybody, my actual name's Brandon. My channel is Crypto Dane. It's going to be about my dogs. I have two Great Danes and a Yorkie Chihuahua mix. Basically going to be doing product reviews, unboxings, some small training segments. One of the biggest things I was trying to work on was how to monetize and if I wanted to change anything when Yen launches. And I'm thinking maybe like a training, like more training, more focused and dedicated towards that. As far as like a subscription plan or something like that.
Okay.
So.
So with that subscription plan, then what kind of options or what would you be offering? So would you do like just I know we you had written earlier like the treats and stuff.
Yeah, oh yeah, I left that one out. My bad.
So making your own treats and like shipping them or
I wanted to do something like that. I need to look into the regulations with the FDA and all that good stuff. So, for right now, I've seen a lot of videos and it seems like a lot of channels just show you guys or show everybody how to do it, show everybody where they got the ingredients. There was some molds that I used for the ones that we did like 10 minutes ago. Let me go get that real quick. Hold on a second. So this is basically what it is by itself, just a mold. And these actually just came out of the freezer right now. So it's just a
Just
bunch
like
of
cookies and
it's
cream.
blueberries, plain yogurt, peanut butter, the good kind. And with the treats and stuff like that, mainly what I want to work on is eventually I want to research, some of the healthiest, micronutrients, things like that, actual health facts, not just some stuff that I found online. Maybe do some research and start incorporating some of those into some of the treats, just like a
Okay,
health, healthier treats and.
so things with like antibiotics, like I know my dog has a sen or one of my dogs has a sensitive stomach, so the prebiotics, I think.
Probiotics, yeah.
Probiotics, yeah. So with that helps, his digestive tract and all that, and he doesn't throw up his food or get an upset stomach. So essentially, that's what you're looking into is kind of all those different kinds of things
Yeah,
for
there's
benefits.
I'm trying to think of the name of it, but help me out if you know what I'm talking about. They have them at airports. I know they're big there now. There's a couple in my town. It's basically like a it's not for dogs. It's like pro workout shakes and just healthy shakes, and they boast that it's made with all natural ingredients, and they got like catchy names like Thunder Energizer or whatever, just for example, and it'll break down what it's got in it, what it's supposed to do, whether it's supposed to be like a high, like more like high protein or a low fat.
So is it like a Smoothie King type thing?
Yeah,
Like,
Smoothie, that's what it was. Smoothie King.
okay.
Yeah. So something along those lines, like I'll have different kicks, different ingredients for different things. I can go into I can break it down, make videos about some of the things that we use in them, why we use them.
Mm-hmm. That's very cool. That's a good idea. Yeah.
It's all very new. It's fun though. Mainly some of the hardest things I've been struggling with is just the editing and technology and getting all this stuff down. I feel like an old man.
Hey, I'm right there with you. It's been 12 years or so since I've kind of messed with this since high school. So it's relearning everything, you know, and then everything's updated and changed and different. So it's like, okay, this is not even anywhere close to what I was used to using. But all right, well, that's very cool. So say you create the Dog Smoothie King. Is there any plans after that? Like any other goals you want to achieve, or is there any like other startups that you have in mind based around dogs, or?
No, not really. Nothing planned yet. Mm-hmm.
So if it comes, it comes, and then, but that's good. Yeah. So you got a main focus.
Yeah.
Where you're going to stick to.
Yeah, just organizing the channel, that's another thing I'm working on right now too. So I don't want to just have random videos every day about random stuff. I was wanting to maybe have Saturdays where I, you know, smoke treats or make treats or whatever. Maybe, you know, just dedicate certain days for different things.
Mm-hmm. And that's actually where you and I are kind of alike on that. So right now I'm kind of doing random videos because my whole point is just, you know, I'm just I'm just getting experience. I'm just trying to be out there, learn, talk, all that stuff. And so my issue, I guess, with that is I was kind of like, I don't know what I want to do. I want to do dogs, but I want to do cars, but I want to do computers, but I want to do guns. But dogs would probably be the easiest for me to do. So I figured I'd start there. But then that was also one of the bigger markets that I figured I could tap into. So
yeah, actually there was, I think $9 billion in revenue just with dog treats last year. So
yeah, I think you had that in your video, the other, like one of your last week videos or something like that.
I might have.
Yeah. So, cause that just like popped up in my head.
I guess I'll go ahead and ask you some questions. So.
All right.
I guess just go ahead and start with what your channel is, what it's all about, your ideas.
Okay. So I guess I would have kept the name R&W Corgi, but
yeah, that's actually something I wanted to talk to you about with the name. How do you feel about my name, Crypto Dane? Do you think it's going to confuse people?
Why would it confuse people?
I don't know. Everybody keeps asking me why I chose Crypto Dane.
Mm, so I don't see a problem with that.
I like cryptocurrency and dogs.
Like
so.
There you go. Yeah. So I guess with mine, R&W was for red and white because I have my little Einstein red and white corgi. Then like 3 weeks ago, we just got a new puppy. So he's a try. He's not red and white. So I can't just be red and white. So my actual channel, I changed to Crypto Corgis. You're Crypto Dane. I'm Crypto Corgi. So
nice.
Essentially we're the same name. Maybe that's why I understand it so well. So I guess essentially what my main goal with the channel is to do, I don't know if you've ever seen Gatsby the Corgi online by any chance, but
yeah, yes.
So you know how he's kind of like a celebrity style dog.
Yep.
Well, me and my wife were both pretty much like that, where we had tried to do Instagram startups and whatnot. But at the time, you had to log out and then log back in onto your other account. There was no like just easy switching. And I was actually on Instagram at the time, so it was a big hassle. Didn't want to do it. So it worked for like a month, and then I was like, nah, I'm throwing this. It's too much just for like 5 views or something, you know,
right.
Something crazy like that. So, when I upgraded to a quartermaster, I didn't really understand yen because I've only been with the pub maybe a month and a half, 2 months now. But I've been around since January-ish, and I just did nothing but tons of reading. So when everybody was kind of like, oh, you know, you've got to upgrade because it's going to be this huge thing. And yen, I understood kind of what it was, but I didn't, you know, how everybody did. We know what it is, but we don't know how to explain it. We don't know how to understand any of it. So with that, I was like, well, I mean, I don't know much about yen, but I want to learn more about it. And so they had the quartermaster meeting, and then I just went ahead and upgraded. With that, when I learned and they said, you know, alpha cohort, we did the first class. That's when I was like, dude, I have no idea what I want to talk about. But I started brainstorming, started coming up with this idea that, you know, my dogs are my kids. And so I want everything, like I will work hard so my dogs have a better life. I don't care about, I like my life, but I want them to have a good life. So I was like, okay, well, you know, I watched Gatsby. Gatsby was one of the reasons why I got a corgi in the first place. So I was like, oh man, I really want a corgi, gotta have one. Wife loved them. So we agreed on that, got corgis. So I want to make them, in a way, celebrities. So if we're going to car shows, if we're going to, you know, try out new products, if we're going to, you know, meetups, anything that we can do, I just want to have them as like the center. Like the camera's not so much going to be on me. It's going to be focused on them. And they're going to be my selling driving point. They're going to be the mascots for the entire thing. So with that, I was thinking, once you get a following, a base, you know, then you have people who are coming to the channel. I can say, hey, look, I just bought this new dog bed. I just bought these treats from Crypto Dane, and you know, he's starting up his business. I wanted to give it a try. He's having a discount or something, you know? So if you go try it in that way, I can do like affiliate marketing. Yep. I can do multiple different things there. I also wanted to do,
I have a great idea.
I've said it so many times now with Grammaton this past video. So it's like, okay, I know exactly what I want to say, but have I already said it? So yeah, essentially I want, you know, have them there. I want to eventually spread out to corgis and all dog breeds. But the end goal, once everything's paid off, once everything's, you know, we're living comfortably, we've got enough saved up and everything, and we can fully quit our jobs if I haven't, at least, she might be still working at the time, will be to start up a doggy daycare. Which there are tons of them around here in the Dallas area, but they're all full.
Oh, wow. Yeah, so, we don't have a lot around here, so.
Yeah, I mean, they're packed here, and since more people from California just moved here, they're even more packed because more people are just coming in and doing that. So it's a really big market, but we've always talked about, you know, having that, having a kennel. Then we also want to have that as like a dog rescue. So, you know, dogs in kill shelters, get them out of kill shelters, get them into homes, do all that kind of stuff. Even talked about doing, like with Grammaton, he wanted to like help veterans and do all that stuff. So we'd be also, either doing donations or, helping companies that do service dogs. So, you know, you start with a small project, but essentially what I want to do is you have to start somewhere, make a base and then expand that out. So that was kind of my thing. And the ways I can do it is, affiliate marketing, just having the subscriptions, or I've thought about doing like episodes of, we're making home treats or something like that too.
Nice.
So I don't know, there's a lot to go into, but it's just kind of what I've got on paper right now and notes. And whenever I come up with an idea, I'm just like, don't write that down.
Yeah, stay with the sticky notes.
Exactly. And I have them all over at work. I'm just like,
yeah, I got them everywhere. I've actually upgraded to these guys here.
The sticky notes, 3x5 note card, or 3x6
note cards. Yeah, yeah. The sticky notes aren't doing it for me.
Nice.
What editing software do you use?
So
are you sticking with the free or the cheap right now, or did you just?
Yeah, what I'm doing right now, is the Premiere Pro is like $600 if you pay it all up in front or something like that.
Oh, we're out. Wow.
And you can pay it monthly, but it'll cost a little bit more, and then you can pay it just monthly and no.
Yeah, 30 a month. That's not bad. When you throw this, I'm only paying $360 a year.
Maybe I was looking at a different project, but the one I am using now is called where'd it go? Oh, it's called DaVinci.
I've never heard of that.
It was one that when I was looking it up, because like Final Cut Pro, you can't use unless you have Apple, which I don't.
Yeah, Apple. Yeah, I was researching that today, actually.
Yeah, so I was looking up free options, but I didn't want really, really basic stuff, like the video shop that I have on my phone. So if I'm just like, popping one up there and, I'm just going to trim it and do whatever, that's fine. But what was nice about DaVinci is they have a fully free mode, which just has some of the stuff locked out. And then I think it's like $300, but then it's like a lifetime. It's not like a year or anything like that. So right now I'm just trying different ones, seeing what I like, see what's the best for me and what gets it done. So, I mean, it's worked so far. I played with it probably till 1 a.m. two nights ago, and then the past two nights, I guess. So, kind of fun and interesting. Not too bad.
So, is there anything you're looking forward to, or anything you got coming up? Any exciting videos you're trying to work on, or anything like that?
I've pretty much pre-recorded a few. I've been pretty bad about my videos lately. Mainly because, we were having the technical issues with Grammaton, so all of yesterday was taken up. The day before that, I was playing with the editor, trying new things. I had video from like Sunday and Monday that I haven't even like touched. I recorded more on Monday, and then I recorded more today because I got a gimbal, which is what my phone's on right now.
Oh, you got the Osmo?
I got the Smooth 4.
I was looking at the Osmo too, but one second.
If you write Grilling with Guns, or I can send you his affiliate link if
that's okay. You're interested. Cool.
But yeah, he had it, and he had Android too. And apparently iPhone is way better with that one. But they're releasing more stuff for the Androids. But I mean, so far it works perfectly fine. Everything. Cool. I just did the firmware update, and I mean, I'm more retarded with it, but I've gotten better.
So yeah. I have an iPhone 7 Plus, and I just figured out today how to change my settings. I've been recording for slow motion. It's been 720p with, I think, 250 frames, I think. I changed that to 1080p, 60 frames, or 120 frames, 1080p. And then my main camera on that, I guess, is a 4K. I didn't even know that. So I was able to change that. That's what was caused me issues earlier on the file size. It was just going from the 1080 to the 4K. It's crazy.
Yeah, 4K will be huge.
Yep. So that's probably about 14 minutes, right?
I think it was a little bit longer. The timer stopped a while, but I haven't got the click up thing for...
Okay.
Because it'll give you like a 10-minute warning. The problem was...
I had 15 questions up here for you, but you pretty much answered all of them with the first time we talked.
So. Well, maybe we're just getting better at efficiency now.
Yeah, for sure.
There's no like, well, what about this and what about that? And then, oh, crap, it didn't record or it didn't save. And then it's, okay, let's do it again. Oh, crap.
Now
it's
I actually had to do that with a scene earlier. I had my wife was filling those molds with the mixture to put it in the freezer. Mm-hmm. And I thought I was recording halfway into it. We had to dump it back into the bowl, wash the mold out, and just start over again. So,
yeah, I guess Grillin had that too. He put up a post in the chat saying like he was talking to the camera for an hour, realized it wasn't even wrong.
I've done that with my mic actually. Like I'll be recording and the mic.
And then you don't have it on. Yeah.
No audio. Yep, that was pretty much it. Oh, it was good talking to you, man. It's good learning about your channel. And I knew you were doing the dog channel, so I figured it'd be really good to partner up and do the collab with you. So.
Yeah, and I think that'll be good because we can both, you know, ping pong ideas off each other and, you know, if you have any questions on anything or have any advice, I'm always down for advice or whatever you think is helpful. And then, you know, I'm willing to do the same too. So if you have any questions or if you're like, hey, I want to know about this or hey, I want to know about that, or have you experienced this? So I don't know, a little bit of training going on there with experience. So
yeah. All right, man. Well, yeah, it was good talking to you. So,
all right. Well, have a good night.
All right. You too, man. Good talking to you.
Bye. Have a good one.